Hello everyone, I am N. Divya, working as TGT Science in Midodi Model School. I am here to discuss the topic structure of a leaf. Before going to the topic, let us revise what we know about the leaf. Leaves are green in color because they contain pigment called chlorophyll. Leaves are of different shapes and sizes, but there are some common parts for all of the leaves. And leaves are also known as kitchen of the plant as they prepare food for the plant through the process of photosynthesis. Now we will learn the common parts of all leaves. Structure of a leaf. Here is a diagram of a leaf, children. Starting with lamina. Lamina is the green flat surface of the leaf. Lamina appears green because it contains chlorophyll. Over the lamina there are many small pores called stomata. On lamina you will find a web-like structure. These are known as veins. Veins are of three kinds. First one, the thick long vein running in the middle of the leaf is known as midrib. On either side of the midribs you find shorter veins. These are known as veins. And there are still thinner veins branching out of each vein. These are known as veinlets. And at the bottom of the leaf, you find a tube-like structure known as petiole. Petiole is a tube which connects leaf lamina to the stem. It carries material brought by the stem into the leaf and takes the materials prepared by leaf into the stem. So this is the structure of a leaf, children. Now let us try to locate all those parts on a real leaf. So here is a leaf, children. Let us try to locate all the parts which we have learnt now. The flat green surface here is lamina. This tube-like structure that joins leaf to the stem is known as petiole. And the longest thick vein running in the middle of the leaf is known as midrib. On either side of midrib, you find shorter veins known as veins. And there are still thinner veins branching out of each vein. These are known as veinlets.